In recent times, a lot of companies from the Middle East, South Africa and Europe are moving into sub-Saharan Africa for investment. And Nigeria, with a population of over 160 million people and a growing middle class, is a choice market for these investors. Specifically, South Africa's investment in Nigeria, which began as a freakle after apartheid in 1994, has turned into a flood over the past 13 years. Trade between the two nations jumped from $11 million in 1994 to well over $100 billion today, with visible investment in the nation's ICT sector. This figure is yet to increase as South Africa recently organized a trade mission visit to Nigeria.
More and more South Africans have been coming here and they would like to invest here. The reason also is basically that Nigeria is quite a big market and therefore it makes business sense for any South African to come and invest here. And of course the legal regime is also very friendly to that.
Deliberations at the event focused on ICT and oil and gas, and participants from Nigeria and South Africa share their perspectives from the government and public sector angles.
We've been coming here regularly to Nigeria, not just to Nigeria but also to other countries. But in Nigeria we come here at least twice a year with different sectors. This time it is oil and gas and ICT sectors, but we were here a few months ago with a film sector. So we brought a group of film producers to come and partner with Nigerian producers so that there can be like some sort of joint production between the two sides. So, and it's been working.
It is important to note that South African investors have chosen the sectors they intervene in very carefully. They feel a void in investment space in Nigeria. The Europeans and Americans, wearied by endless years of military rule, did not quite know how to respond to Nigeria's evolving democratic environment. Most West African companies that invested in Nigeria focused on the lucrative oil sector alone, leaving huge swaths of the economy open to South African entrepreneurs.
Although the two countries have done well in their trade relations, there are still some barriers that must give way if this growth must be sustained. And this is about to change, says the South African High Commissioner to Nigeria.
During the state visit, we signed an agreement where at least carriers of diplomatic and official passports could move freely between the two countries.
It is hoped that these deliberations and networking will result in significant improvement in the trade and investments flow between the two countries.